The date, August 21st of 2017.
Happy Eclipse Day, everyone!
The occasion, one of the biggest celestial events in U.S. history, a total solar eclipse. Derek Roll knows a thing or two about solar eclipses. He's the planetarium manager at the Adventure Science Center. They spent more than a year preparing for this event.
These days we can actually predict them within 1/100th of a second. And so that's one of my favorite things about science is the fact that we can predict this isn't all that new, but we are predicting them better than ever, which lets us prepare even more science experiments that we can try once we know that they're happening.
Scientists have been predicting solar eclipses for a long time, but we didn't always understand this phenomenon.
Now, when it first happened, people maybe didn't know it was coming. And they would have all sorts of great stories that they would tell, whether it's a serpent consuming the sun or a dragon chomping some bites out of the sun or anything that they can do to scare these, you know, sort of monsters away in the sky. Once we learned to predict them a little bit better, it scared people just a little bit less.
When the big day arrived in Nashville, there was definitely no fear, only excitement.
We're coming in! Right.
Have a nice day!
Folks flocked to the Adventure Science Center and watched in awe as the sky darkened.
Go Solar! Go
Solar! It was really amazing to be down here and watch the solar total eclipse. Everyone was cheering as the sky got darker and the sunset was beautiful. I don't have to tell you, you saw it all. So right now I'm actually talking to Madeline. She's 9 years old and she came all the way here from Michigan to experience the solar eclipse. So Madeline, how was it watching the eclipse?
It was awesome, but the cloud blocked the way, so it was not what I expected, but it was still super duper cool.
Is this your first time seeing a total solar eclipse?
Yes.
Yeah? Was it, I know you said it wasn't what you expected, but what part did you like the most?
I liked when it was completely black and me and my friends were so excited.
Nashville won't see another total solar eclipse for quite a while. So what should you do with all that leftover excitement?
So rather than people maybe saying, okay, science was nice and moving on, sort of the contrary happens with an eclipse, and people become what we call eclipse chasers and start to actually travel all around the world. I know people who charter cruises or work with airlines to reschedule and reroute flights just to fall in that shadow one more time.
We met one of those total solar eclipse chasers at the Adventure Science Center, but Gary Parkinson didn't travel to Music City by air or sea. He came to Nashville on a bike.
So, how far did you travel to be here today?
I've traveled 9,300 miles so far to be here. I've traveled on this bicycle through 37 states. When I started out, my goal was to do all 48 before the eclipse. I didn't quite make it. I've got 11 more to do, and I'll finish those up in the next couple of months.
So how did you start chasing eclipses?
I became aware of this particular eclipse when I was 13 years old in 1967. I saw a list of future eclipses and realized that this one was going to go coast to coast and that was special. So I've been waiting for this for 50 years.
Okay, if taking long rides to chase solar eclipses is not your style, just take a quick journey to the Adventure Science Center. This is a place where you can take in the wonders of science any day of the
week. We're all about inspiring curiosity and igniting and, you know, really inspiring people to continue to explore careers in science for young kids, but also to really just embrace the kid in everyone and, you know, and have everyone explore the science. So we're not just for kids anymore either.
The Adventure Science Center plans to create an area devoted to preschoolers, and they regularly host events for those of us who are long past the playdate phase. But this is not the only way students can get hands-on science learning. David Lockett is a middle school STEM teacher who also happens to be a NASA Solar System Ambassador. This is a national volunteer program that educates communities about space exploration and science in general. David also gives his time with other teaching projects.
We've got two National Science Foundation projects we're working on. One is called iData, and that is innovators developing accessible tools for astronomy. This project enables vision impaired and blind students to better understand our galaxy, whether it's 3D printing, whether it's tactile astronomy. We want all students to experience astronomy just as we do. Another project is the Astronomy in Chile Educator Ambassadors Program. This project involves American astronomers, teachers, and educators visiting different observatories in Chile in order to make astrotourism available to the masses. We want everyone to have that astronomy knowledge, so what better way than to not only be a national part of this, but a worldwide part of it as well. Who's heard of solar energy before?
David believes it's important for children to explore. He hopes that experiencing the total solar eclipse sparked curiosity in his students.
Well, you know, after the solar eclipse, I want the learning to continue. I don't want it to stop. I want it to be a pathway to bigger and more broader science terms. You know, I want students to say, wow, now that I know a little bit about the eclipse, maybe now I can research something else. Maybe now I can truly understand why certain planets are gassy, why certain planets are rocky, why certain planets are liquid. I want them to come away with a better understanding of our solar system.
The total solar eclipse of 2017 was a once-in-a-lifetime event, but it may have laid the groundwork for a lifetime of learning.
Eclipse on three. One, two, three. Eclipse!